Now, let us discuss briefly the philosophy of critical pedagogy. Philosophy of critical pedagogy has its root with ideals of Paulo Freire. As you know, Freire was a Brazilian educational philosopher. Paulo Freire wrote many books on education and pedagogy. Some of them are Pedagogy of the Oppressed, you know, the bestseller in the world, and Pedagogy of Hope, Politics of Education, Culture, Power and Education, Education for Critical Consciousness, like that. His influential work, Pedagogy of the Oppressed, is generally considered one of the foundational texts of the critical pedagogy movement. Freire is the most identified propagator of the critical pedagogy. Freire, in Pedagogy of the Oppressed, describes the oppressors and oppressed. He claimed that education is designed according to the interest of the oppressors wherever in the world. Education should allow oppressors to regain their sense of humanity and life condition that he actually aimed. Freire recognized that oppressed people must play a big role in their liberation through education. Education is not a new knowledge tool, but a political tool. So remember this one, that is the basics of critical pedagogy. Education is not a knowledge tool, but education is a political tool. Critical pedagogy is based upon this idea. Let us discuss what are the ways of oppression and actions without critical thinking, as Paulo Freire explained. Just to think of the teeth cleaning system, I mean brushing methods that we Indians followed. We had own traditional systems to clean our teeth or brushing in all states and regions of the country. I mean, Kerala have a system, Karnataka have a system, Maharashtra have a system, Bihar have a system. And the people used different methods to clean their teeth. Even then, we changed to the toothbrush and paste for our morning mouthwash. By what way? We got a lot of advertisement and somebody thought that paste is better and brush is better. What happened? We missed our culture of own methods and practices and became the part of the world trends. We accepted brush and paste. We never critically thought on the replacement of this for our traditional systems of teeth cleaning. What I mean, we became passive listeners of the advertisements and believed brush and paste is better than the traditional methods. We missed our critical thinking. Like that, colonial and oppressing tendencies may change our vision and culture. A remedy to this method of banking education is the critical pedagogy and progressive education. While discussing the critical pedagogy and Paulo Freire, we must note some terms. They are banking concept of education, silence of culture, praxis, problem posed education, dialogue, and critical consciousness. By going through these terms, we can have an exact idea on what critical pedagogy is. Let us discuss banking education. It is a metaphor used by Freire to describe his views on education. He actually reflects the method of present system of teaching learning by the phrase banking education. In this system, he explains knowledge is not a material to be discussed or developed by the learner. Instead, knowledge becoming a material only to be deposited. In banking education, the problem is that knowledge is becoming a material only to be deposited. Teachers make deposit of knowledge or information into the empty accounts of students' cognition. We are considering students' cognition is an empty account and teacher depositing knowledge to it. It means depositing knowledge to the cognition of students. This is almost similar like one person operates a bank account to deposit and withdraw cash. simply like we deposit money into account and withdraw it by check or DD or withdrawal slip or through other way. The education system deposit information or knowledge to the student's cognition and withdraw it by different ways of evaluation and examination, like quarterly examination, annual examination, unit test, and so. So, depositing the knowledge and withdrawing the knowledge. In banking education, as convinced by Freyer, students are the depositories and teachers are the depositors. Students receive, memorize, and repeat knowledge. It lacks critical thinking. This is the idea of the present education system that Paulo Freire explained. The concept that explains teaching learning as a process of knowledge depositing in the learner by the teacher without the progression of proper discussion or dialogue on learning material is called banking education. Education that do not develop students' own thinking is to be redefined, and banking education system must be eradicated. FRIAR stands for Progressive Education and Problem-Posed Method that developed critical thinking. Now, we can brief the features of concept of banking education. Teacher is the center of classroom teaching. Students are always the receivers. That is the primary feature of banking education. And another thing is, banking education denotes that teacher knows everything and students know nothing new. Teacher thinks and the students are thought about. Teacher is always the investor of knowledge. This is the peculiar feature of banking concept explained by Freyer. Another thing is that the teacher chooses and enforces their choice of teaching and the students act in accordance with. The teachers choose the program content, teaching material and methods according to their interest and the students adapt to it. Another important feature of banking education is that the teachers confuse the authority of knowledge with their own professional authority, which mostly set in opposition to the freedom of students in selecting. So, banking concept of education rejecting the freedom of students in selecting the learning material and learning content. In another way, banking system suppresses students' metacognitive capacities and procedural ways to acquire knowledge. They fail to spot critical thinking and becoming mechanical learners as the acceptors of knowledge. So, this is about the banking concept of education that rejects the methods of present teaching and accepts the critical thinking and critical pedagogy. Now, let us discuss another features. Instead of banking education, according to Freyer, what we need is progressive education. Problem posing is an alternative method of progressive education suggested by Paulo Freyer, instead of the existing authoritarian and oppressing banking education. It is based on the principle that a student learns better when he creates knowledge and when knowledge is created for him. The term problem posing is used because in this type of education, the whole learning is driven by a problem that emerges from the life situation of the learners. So, the situation to learn a content is speaking from the life situation of the learners, not from everywhere. On other hand, in problem posing education, learning always begins from a problem thrown up in the classroom, and that problem will be closely connected with learners' interest. The problem is modeled to learners to solve. To the learners, it is an issue so that the students discover what new knowledge they need to learn to solve the problem. Then the teacher have much responsibilities. What are the responsibilities of the teacher? It includes to diversify subject matter and to use students' thought and speech. That is important, to use students' thought and speech. Make the students' thought and speech as the base for developing critical understanding of personal experience and existing knowledge. Problem-posing education encourages students to become active in thinking about and acting upon their world. It involves co-creation of knowledge in which the teacher and students learn together. That is really a fantastic idea. The teacher and students learn together from the classroom. Problem-posing method opens doors to critically analyze the hidden curriculum. The teacher acts as a mediator and organizer of learning and barely comes up with any content teaching ideas. Encourages the students to think critically. It ensures democratic teaching-student relations. Problem-posing ignites praxis and leads to action. In the problem-posing method, teachers and students learn together through dialogue. There is another word that we have to explain is conscientization. Critical pedagogy aims to develop critical consciousness or critical awareness in the learner. This can be denoted with the term conscientization. It is the ability to critically perceive the causes of social, political, and economic oppression. Conscientization makes the learners able to take action against the oppressive elements of the society. It is a situation of in-depth understanding about the world and resulting from freedom from oppression.